Hey, brothers and sisters, I want to make a quick video this morning. I had this night vision last night. Didn't get a lot of sleep. I had this night vision, and I don't really know the exact meaning of it, and I wanted to share it. Like I said, I usually don't share all the things the Lord shows me, but I think it's important. Because the Bible says there is wisdom in a multitude of counsel. So anyway, what happened is I had this dream. I'd woken up. It was a night vision. I was awake, but just like awake, but not up, not out of bed. And I saw this, the top of the back of the dollar bill, where is the great seal of the United States, the backside of it, the obverse side of it. And on it was the all-seeing eye, that's the capstone on the Great Pyramid. And that all-seeing eye, brothers and sisters, it got right up all up in my face. I mean, it got in my face, like it zoomed in on me, and then I was like, not fully awake, and I was like, what's up with that? And then it zoomed in again so close that I really thought it was going to hit me. And I would even like turn my head to the side like, whoa, this thing's going to hit me. I mean, it was that real. And the thing about it is that on the around, you know, it was just the capstone, not the whole pyramid, but the pyramid, little pyramid capstone with the all-seeing eye. And then beside it, brothers and sisters, specifically, I saw the head of Thomas Jefferson pierce through the, not with it right beside the all-seeing eye, but still inside the triangle. And it was specifically Thomas Jefferson's portrait that's on the nickel, the American 5 cents piece. The hair and all that was specifically from the nickel. And it was very specific. And then I kept seeing like someone taking a giant hand, kept, you know, peeling off that eye or unsealing, removing the seal, kept removing the seal. And then I saw the triangle again, you know, the little pyramid that's on top of the pyramid, but there was no eye in it. This time I saw like two nickels facing each other, but it was, you know, it was the silhouette or the side view of that portrait of Thomas Jefferson. So it was specifically the same image of Thomas Jefferson that's on the 5 cents piece. And it was two of him facing each other, like, you know, they were facing toward the center of that little triangle, and then there was no all-seeing eye anymore. So just now as I'm saying it out loud, I'm thinking that it could be, you know, like the Lord would reveal, you know, who's behind the all-seeing eye. Well, of course, we know that it's Satan, it's Lucifer, it's Horus, and all this kind of stuff from Egypt, you know, the eye of Horus. But, of course, it's Lucifer. But it's from the back of the dollar, and the Lord was really like unveiling or removing, unsealing that. And I believe the Lord is really going to continue to reveal to me. I think the interpretation, I mean, what all about Thomas Jefferson? You know, I'd seen a documentary. I saw a documentary, and I believe it was that Tares Among Wheat by Chris Pinto. And I challenge all of you guys to watch it. You need to watch the Tares Among Wheat and then the follow-up, the part two to that. I forgot the name of it, but in that video, I do believe, was where I saw that supposed to be that Thomas Jefferson and the gang were sitting there trying to figure out what's going to be the Great Seal of the United States. And then, you know, some mysterious figure in a black hooded robe. I mean, it's just so theatrical. But supposed to be that a guy with a black hooded robe showed up and hands, you know, Thomas Jefferson goes outside for, you know, to walk around while they're pondering, you know, what's going to be the Great Seal of the United States. And supposedly this figure, you know, hands him, you know, like the Illuminati, or it was a fallen angel or Satan himself. They claimed that Thomas Jefferson said that the person never spoke, and, you know, they thought it was like a supernatural event. Satan, Lucifer, or a fallen angel or something handed him this bag, like a silk bag or a satin bag, and in that bag was the Great Seal, like a giant coin. And then, of course, Thomas Jefferson, you know, is attributed that. He was a deist, Now, I know on Christian television, there's a guy, I believe his name is Barth, who's supposed to be a historian, and he keeps trying to say that the founding fathers were Christians. But in reality, if you will study Thomas Jefferson as an example, you will see he was a deist. What we learned in school, what I learned in 10th grade or 11th grade, literature and all that, Thomas Jefferson was a deist, and it's really true. He made his own Bible. He cut out all the parts about Jesus being the Son of God, about anything, miracles he did and all that. He made like a Gnostic Bible and made Jesus just a great man who said some wise things. You know, that's what he did. So he was definitely not a born-again Christian. He was a deist. And I was thinking about that last night after the Lord showed me that, and I was going to look it up. I haven't had time to. I don't necessarily think it's important, but I like to give references to the things that I would say is factual. But nowadays, anybody can look these things up on Google. When George Washington died, after he died, he had a pastor for like 30 years. I think he was Episcopalian or something. And they asked his preacher, like, what was George Washington's faith? And I can't remember the quote, but he was basically saying, like, well, you know, it's not really that George Washington was really too much of a Christian either. Most of those guys were all Masons. All but two people who signed the Constitution are Masons. And they were deists, which means they believe that the creator of the universe, the great architect of the universe, is what the Masons call what they say is God, really Lucifer, is a great architect of the universe, and then he just wound it up and walked away. Wound it up like a clock. Wound up the creation and walked away. Now that's what it means to be a deist. That God is, you can't know God, God doesn't have a personal relationship with people, and he just created and that's it. And that was the profounding wisdom at that time of the Age of Enlightenment, coming out of the Renaissance, and you know, Thomas Jefferson was known as a Renaissance man, you know, a jack of all trades, and he dabbled in all the, you know, the these kind of things. Like he built a dome there in his house, and a lot of those guys did. And they were tapping into the Rosicrucian, Knights Templar, all the way back to Babylonian ideas about the world and everything, really. Just carrying on the same belief system that the modern-day Masons have today in those kind of groups, a Gnostic. Salvation through wisdom and knowledge. Sort of salvation through the tree of the knowledge of good and evil instead of salvation through the tree of life. Instead of going to the Lord Jesus Christ, they go to use their own mind and try to get unauthorized access to the wisdom of God. That's what they're trying to do. So, anyway, brothers and sisters, I want to put that out there. And if any of you guys have some more additions or ideas about what the vision could mean beyond what I've already been saying, touching on it. You know, last night, then I was able to go back to sleep for a little while, and then today I've been thinking about it, and then I just prayed. I didn't hear anything from the Lord other than, the Lord told me, I want you to know. So I believe the Lord is going to reveal to me, you know, who's the Antichrist. And, you know, it must be, I will say this, because it's time for it to go down. I believe that, you know, for me, in my personal opinion, the things the Lord showed me, you know, I've talked about this before. The Lord has shown me, you know, about Baphomet and really the fact that the Antichrist is probably androgynous. I've been talking about that way back in my videos 3 or 4 years ago. They didn't either be male nor female. I saw a brother who had made a video, Face Like the Sun, and I just saw his video last night. And he was talking about Akhenaten. And if you guys have been following me, you know that about 4 years, before I ever started YouTube, the Lord started me on this search about the New World Order and the Antichrist, as the Lord had directed me, was the first thing he told me was, you know, read Enoch and study Akhenaten. That's where I started at, in 2008, 2009. And so Akhenaten, and I never thought about this too much, but with this brother, Face Like the Sun, and I recommend you watch his videos, he does great work. Professional presentations. He was saying that, of course, Akhenaten, if you look at his statues, he's like neither male nor female. He looks like some kind of he's got the body of a woman. And so it's been said he had some handicaps and all this. And, you know, his son died at a young age. King Tut, the famous King Tut, was his son, Tutankhamun. And supposed to be that, you know, he had some genetic disorder and all this kind of stuff. I don't know. But the departure of Akhenaten is the fact that he started a religion of just one god, the sun god, Akhen. You know, that's why it's Akhenaten. He started this religion, and then he also had the artwork made about him to look realistic. Obviously, whatever, he was some kind of a freak. You know, I don't know if he had a genetic disorder or he was some kind of androgynous, you know, Nephilim, whatever. But the pictures of the pharaohs and kings in history, if you'll look, they always make them look good, of course, flattering. So the artwork of him is not flattering. That's why it's a big departure, something totally different. It's probably how he really looked, and it looks goofy, and it doesn't look good. It's not flattering, and so it's pretty weird. It's just like another, to me, a confirmation that the Bible is real. Because in the Bible, we see the good and the bad and the ugly about the kings. We see bad things written about King David, what he did. And if you were the king and then your son, like Solomon, became the king, if you're this, you know, Solomon, and then there's some bad stuff written about your dad, you know, you're going to go have that scrub from the record. You know, the legend of your dad being so great would grow. The story of him defeating Goliath would be the big news. Nothing about Bathsheba and all that, especially since Solomon was the result of this adulterous relationship. But yet God, by his grace, forgave King David, as we see King David repenting in the 51st Psalm, asking the Lord to restore a right spirit within him and not, you know, don't let your spirit depart from me. And King David repented, and God, you know, forgave him, and went on to be that he married Bathsheba. And, you know, Solomon was a product of that marriage. And I guess the Lord is leading me to say that because, you know, there's been some people making in the past who hurt a lot of people, making videos basically saying divorce was an unforgivable sin and adultery and all this kind of stuff. All sin is sin. And we can be forgiven of any sin, save blaspheming the Holy Spirit, according to the Lord Jesus Christ. So, King David, who was a man after God's own heart, who God raised up his seed to be the ruler over the world forever, that's Jesus Christ, is a direct descendant of King David through Mary. And God honored King David and to have someone on his throne for eternity. The Lord Jesus Christ, and even the son of this adulterous, you know, he had an adulterous relationship, then ended up marrying Bathsheba and having a son later on with her that became King Solomon, one of the most famous people in the Bibles, and very blessed. King Solomon was blessed with wisdom and riches and all these things. So there is grace in the Old Testament, and there is grace, and God can forgive you of any sin. Brothers and sisters, don't let any of these old Pharisees try to put some burden on you that King David didn't have to honor. Because the Bible says that too much given is much required. And King David was very intimate with the Lord and knew the Lord very well. He was highly anointed and authority in his day over, you know, anybody, and knew better what he was doing. But yet, after God chastised him, he repented and he was forgiven. And he went, you know, everything went forward. And, you know, God restored him. And God can restore you no matter what you've done. I don't care if it's homosexuality, adultery, whatever. Any kind of sin. Kill somebody. There are people who are murderers who will be in heaven because they repented. And God will do the same thing for you, brothers and sisters. Don't let any of these old Pharisees put their old religious, demonic, satanic lies on you. That the blood of Jesus is not sufficient for you. That the grace of the Lord is not sufficient for you. For his grace is sufficient for us. Praise God Almighty. His blood is able. He's able to do exceedingly abundantly above all we can ask or think. He is able to save us to the uttermost, the Bible says. Praise God that we can be born again and saved and delivered and forgiven and our sins removed, the Bible says. As far as the east is from the west, so shall our sins be from us, the Bible says. Says God will cast our sins into the sea of forgetfulness and remember them no more. God will not remember our sin. You need to renew your mind with what the Word says and not what some old demon Pharisee on YouTube might tell you. Go with the Word. Reject the wisdom of man and walk in the wisdom of God through His Word. Renew your mind, the Bible says, with the Word of God. Bring every vain thought and imagination into captivity to the Word of God. God bless you guys. The Lord's just dumping all kinds of stuff on me, brothers and sisters. I've got 10 videos to make of the things. The Lord is just, in this season, since I came to the Philippines, praise God, the Lord is just pouring on the wisdom on me. So praise God. There's much more to come, brothers and sisters, by the grace of God. And God would have me to bring this wisdom. And I do believe He will reveal to me by His Spirit, by His grace and mercy, He will allow me to know who's the Antichrist for real. Through confirmations, multiple confirmations, and present it before the rapture happens so that videos will be a posterity to those who will be left behind. And there'll be people who can see those videos, who will be left behind, who might get saved. Who knows, you know, who could see the videos that the Lord would, you know, allow me to make. So praise God for that. That's why we need to diligently seek Him. And whatever He tells us to talk about, that's what we talk about. You know, whatever He's leading us. By the gospel, the whole counsel of God, the whole counsel of God, whatever that may be. So praise God, brothers and sisters. God bless you. I'll be back later on as I need to do some more studying, and the Lord has dropped several more things on me, and I got to go study out what it means and pray about it for more wisdom. But I ask for your help with this one vision, a night vision that I had. God bless.